Hello students, in EVS we have finished lesson 1 to 10 and in today's video we are going to do the revision of lesson 1 to 5 and we will focus only on true false. So let's begin. So here we are going to do the revision of lesson 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, but we will do only true false in this revision video. Okay, so write true or false for each statement. Students, when you are writing exam, always read the question, what they are asking. Are they asking true false or are they asking right or wrong? And accordingly you have to write. And when you're writing true false like this, you have to see the spelling from here so that you may not go wrong. See the spelling of true, T-R-U-E. Many children make mistake by writing turu, T-U-R-U. So it's like you're not paying attention there. And even false spelling, you have to see F-A-L-S-E. There also during exam time, children write F-L-A-S-E. So they get wrong. Why? Because the spelling is wrong. So you should see to it that you're writing the right spellings here in the answer. Okay. Now first, we are grown up when we are born. Now in this statement, I will show you through some simple drawings so that you'll understand the meaning of the statement. Some children, they can make out immediately that this is right or wrong, means true or false. But some students, they don't understand. So you have to make you understand. I'm just drawing and showing. This is saying that this statement is saying we are grown up. We are grown up when we are born. When we are born, we are grown up. No. So this is false. Second, our parents look after us when we are young. See here in this picture, when we are young, who's taking care of us? Our parents only, no? So this statement is true. Third, a baby looks like people in other families. Now here they are saying that, suppose this is one family. Here, mother, father and children. This is one family. Here, other family is there. Mother, father and children. Now when we read this statement, a baby looks like people in other family, means this baby is looking like this family. No, we look like our parents only, we don't look like other family people. So this statement is wrong. So it is false. We look like our mother or father when we grow up. When we are small and when we grow up, we look like with our mummy or daddy. Yes, so we look like our mother or father when we grow up. Grow up means when we grow up, we look like our parents. See now, when we are small, then we grow up. When we grow up, we look like our parents. Fifth one, members of a family do not look like each other. Now this statement is saying that your members of the family do not look like each other. Means we don't look like our parents or grandparents. So this statement is false. Our nose helps to move food in the mouth. Now our nose is a nose, okay? It is helping the food to go in the mouth? No. So it's false. Seventh, our skin is waterproof. Our skin means this is our skin. It is waterproof? Yes, it is waterproof. Why we say it is waterproof? Because waterproof means, suppose this is our skin. This is our skin. Okay. It does not allow water. This is water. It is not allowing water to go inside or outside our body. So, this means it is waterproof. So, it is true. Our skin is waterproof. We feel hotter when we sweat. Now your my skin is there, okay? When it is sweating means pasina aata hai tabhi. Our body is feeling hotter? No. When we sweat means jab pasina aata hai, our body is becoming cool from inside. So whatever statement is written is false. We use our hands to hold things. Now our hand. We can hold thing, no? Suppose pencil I am holding. Or if this I am holding with my hand. So it is true. So we use our hand to hold things. True. I'll show the picture here in the textbook only. So you'll understand. See, you can see. We can hold the pen, we can hold the things to eat, we can hold thing, you're holding the bag, holding the this bag. So we can hold things with our hands. So it is true. See, students always try to understand. Some children and during exam time, what they do? They don't write anything. They don't write true also, they don't write false also. So they get a zero. But if you write, like when you read, try to understand it in your mother tongue, like if you are Marathi, you can just try to understand in Marathi. This is written in English, but you have to translate it and think in your language, so you'll understand, and then you know that your answer is true or false. If you feel that yes, this is whatever is written is right, then put true or false if true or false is asked. Okay. We must include special children in our games. Special children. Wait a minute. We have to use special people in our game. Suppose now this child is, he cannot walk. Maybe because of some accident or something, he is not able to walk. So we should include him in the games or no? Yes, we should include such children in our games. So it is true. Okay. We wear clothes to protect ourselves. Now we are wearing clothes. Why we wear clothes? Suppose girls are wearing dress like this. Why they are wearing? To protect ourselves. So it is true. We wear the same clothes at home and in the school. Now, when you are coming to school, you are wearing school uniform. But when you go home, do you wear the same thing? No. So, whatever is written is false. Indian women usually wear a sari. Now, Indian woman, whenever you must have seen, when you see outside, when you see the woman, you must have seen many of them wearing sari only. Yes, so they wear sari. Okay, so you must have seen ladies wearing woman wearing sari. Most of the Indian women wear sari. Fine. You can see here. I'll show the pictures. See, Indian woman wearing sari. Most of them wear sari. Men wear caps and turbans on their arms. Now, here they are wearing caps, turbans. So, turban they are putting on their head. Okay. So, are they putting on their arms? Arms means हाथ पे बनते क्या? No. So, it is false. It is false. We eat food to get energy. Now, why we eat food? When you're feeling low, like weak. So you eat few food, no? Why? So that we get energy. So whatever statement is written is true. We get our food only from plants. Only from plants we get food. Here you see. We get food from plants. We get food from animals also. So whatever statement is written here is false. They are saying we get our food only from plants. So it is false. Dal is a cereal. See students, I'd explain what are dals. All pulses. Pulses means all types of dals, like tur dal, masoor dal, moong dal, chana dal. They are all pulses. And cereal means we are eating rice, then we are eating wheat, we are eating jawar, bajra, nachni. They are all cereals. We are making wheat chapati, rice chapati also, jawar chapati, bajra chapati, nachni chapati, bakris means. And all dals like tur, then moong, chana dal, then urid dal. Masoor. When I was doing the lesson, I have shown all the pictures. That is why I am not repeating it again here, because this is a revision of true false. But you just recollect it and just understand it. So what they are saying here, dal is a cereal. Dal is a cereal. Here dal you can see, no. So it is false. All places grow the same kind of plants for food. Now they are saying that all places. Now here, suppose Maharashtra. This is Maharashtra. This is Gujarat. This is Rajasthan. Means all different places, they are growing all. Here, suppose Maharashtra, they are growing rice. Rice. So in Gujarat also they are growing rice. Here also rice. No. So this is wrong. Every different places is growing different types of things depending upon the soil and climate there. So whatever sentence is written is wrong. So it is false. Rice is popular in South India. See, I told you. I had shown the map of India like this. This is just rough. Okay. Like this. Now this is South India here. This is, so here people mostly they eat rice. Why? Because it is near to the sea. And what the soil there is good for cultivating rice, means growing. They can when we grow rice there, and there lot of rainfall is there. Because of very high rainfall, they can grow rice. Because rice crop now it requires more of rains. उसको बारिश बहुत चाहिए, पानी बहुत चाहिए उगने के लिए. So that is why in south like there a lot of rainfall is there. And so there people are growing rice more. Okay, so it is true. Fish is common in Rajasthan. Now Rajasthan is here there is no sea, so how they can eat fish there? No, so it is false. We should eat only one kind of food. They are saying, this statement is saying that we should eat only one type of food. Like if I'm eating chapati and I'm eating chapati, dal and rice, so every day I should eat this only? No, you should eat all types. Like you should eat chapati also, rice also, dal also, vegetable also, salads also. We should eat all type of food in proper proportion. So this is wrong. So it is false. Food must be kept covered. Now whatever food, now this is my plate, suppose. Okay. And whatever is there, your food, it should, if it is kept open, what will happen? When you are eating, it has to be open. But if it is, you are not eating now, so you should cover it. Anything mummy has prepared, suppose any vegetable, she has prepared any something, okay? So you should cover it. You should keep it, cover it with a lid, a dish. Whatever food things, food items your mummy has made, or when you are going out, when you see any food items, it should be covered. Then only you should eat it. Otherwise, it may be infected with insects, germs, dust. So it may harm you. So it is true. Food must be kept covered. True. Stale food is good for us. Stale food means the food which is spoiled. जो खराब हो गया खाना, it is good for our body? No. So it is false. We must wash our hands before we eat food. We should wash our hands before we eat our food? Yes, true. We need to drink water to stay healthy. See, we should eat food, and immediately after eating food you should drink little water, but then other time you have to drink more water, like six glass of water in a day. It is very good for our body because it is helping in digesting the food and removing the waste from our body. Okay, so whatever statement is there is true. So students, we have finished with our revision of true and false in this video. And in the next video, we'll be doing the fill in the blanks from lesson 1 to 5. Okay, thank you students.